there, folks. It's Dee Dee here from Healthy Hearing Loss. I am going to cover some stethoscopes today. I gotta take this jacket off, though. Much better. But I'm going to take a little bit of a twist in this video and do something different. So stay with me. I'm going to be covering three different stethoscopes. I've done many videos up to this point on them. The first one is the Thinklabs stethoscope, the digital stethoscope. The second one is the core digital stethoscope. And then the last one is the dual digital stethoscope. The three stethoscopes that I'm going to talk about today is going to be ranked by my experience with using them. And the first one is the Thinklabs stethoscope, which I've been using for the last 10 years. And then I got the core stethoscope, and I've been using that, I think, around 3 years. And then finally, the duo I got was a year ago. I'm also going to share my competency level for the visualization, the waveforms that go with each stethoscope. And that starts with novice to expert. And I'm going to kind of put this graph up here to demonstrate my competency level with these three. And at the bottom, we have the Thinklab, which is the one stethoscope, and learning about their visualization is pretty new to me, so I'm going to call myself a novice in that area. I have a little bit more experience with the duo, and so I think I'm more of an advanced beginner as far as the duo goes. And then finally, the core, I think I'm pretty competent there. Notice that I did not mention proficient or expert, and that is because my learning curve has been continuing and probably will continue for many years to come. If I call myself an expert, then I would leave no room to learn and grow. I'd rather say like mastery, or I master something. So yeah, let's move on. To make it a little easier for myself and for you to keeping the stethoscope straight in our mind, I'm going to color code them by using scrubs. And this is going to be a blue scrub for Thinklabs stethoscope. And now I have the black one that I'm going to use for the core stethoscope. And then finally, I have the gray scrub that's going to be for the duo stethoscope. Just remember those colors and you will stay with me as far as which stethoscope I am talking about. I have a severe to profound sensory neural hearing loss, and I wear two different hearing aids. I have one set of hearing aids that are called the Phonak Cross 2, and that has a hearing aid and a transmitter. And that particular hearing aid has T-coil. And my second hearing aid is the Phonak Adeo, and that has Bluetooth in it. I work as a nurse practitioner in a primary care setting, and I have three different environments that I do my work in. The first environment is a typical clinic office. The second one is conducting house calls. And the third one is street medicine, where I go in encampments, I go to parks, alleys, riversides, that type of thing. I'm also going to add that I either work with an audiologist or not with these stethoscopes. The first one is going to be the Thinklabs stethoscope. I do work with my audiologist with that. And the second one is the core digital stethoscope. And I have talked to my audiologist a little bit about that. And I have not talked to her about my duo as of yet. I encourage people to work with an audiologist because I think it's important. It's important to be able to brainstorm with them and see if there's a best setup that will work with your hearing aid. Talk about the equipment that is needed to capture the waveforms. With the Thinklabs, I use my Phonak Cross, which has T-coil in it. I use the Thinklabs stethoscope, and I also use the ThinkLink. The core, I use the Phonak Adeo, and these have Bluetooth in them. I use the core stethoscope, and I use the iPhone, which is the 12 Pro with the Eko app. And then, of course, the Duo is the same thing. I use the Phonak Adeo with Bluetooth, with the Duo, as well as the phone with the Eko app. I'm also going to kind of rate this. This is my own rating system from 0 to 10, which is going to be poor to excellent. And I'm going to rate the quality of the audio sounds as well as the waveform waveform, the visualization of the waveforms, because sometimes they're not so great, and sometimes they're really great. And the waveforms are going to be for heart sounds, lung sounds, and then finally the EKG tracing. Now, I am going to show you all of this, but just know this is as of today, which is the 1st of March, 2022, and they are always subject to change because technology is always advancing every day. I just got an email the other day in regards to the Eko. There are new Eko features coming soon. Once that is up and running, I will play around with it and do a review or share my experience with that at a later time. I'm going to link what I got in the email so you can kind of update. It's called the Spot Check. And I do know that the Thinklabs is constantly trying to change and advance their features as well. I know that they're looking for ways to do Bluetooth compatibility with different devices, and hopefully one of them will be our hearing aids. Okay, as you can see, I'm wearing my blue scrub, so we're thinking about the Thinklabs stethoscope. And I wanted to point out a couple of things before we get into looking at the waveforms on at the phone itself. There isn't an app on the desktop that I know of, it's just on the phone, and using the Thinklabs Wave app. And I'm going to link all of that in that PDF that I'm going to be sharing down in the description so you can take a look at that. So the couple other items that I needed to also point out in my setup is that I used the Compilot 2 to connect to my T-coil, and I also needed the lightning cord to connect to the ThinkLink that can connect to my iPhone. This is all for the Thinklabs stethoscope. And now I'm going to go ahead and show you what the waveform looks like. The phone always tends to be a little bit softer and not as loud as the desktop. All right, so let's go ahead and open up the Thinklabs Wave app. And you can see that it is a blue app here. If you bring your attention to the top wave, that is your phonocardiogram. Down at the bottom is the spectrogram, and that has colors in it. And you can see that it does do all the way down to 20 hertz up to 200 hertz. That's where it seems to be capturing the sound the most. So take a look at that. That's the Thinklabs Wave application capturing sounds. Maybe in another video I'll show how my setup looks at separately, but this video is becoming a little bit more complex. So yeah, let's get on to the next one, the core. We're going to go ahead and talk about the core digital stethoscope, and we are going to first look on the Eko app. So let me go ahead and open that up. And now you're going to see on the screen now what it looks like on the app itself. This rhythm is the phonocardiogram. Take a few minutes to listen to that. Next, we're going to hop on to our desktop and show you what it looks like on the dashboard.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Now I'm going to go ahead and show you the phononeumogram, which is the lung sound. We'll take a look at that. Okay, that wraps that up. Next, we're going to get to the duo. Okay, and finally, we're going to quickly look at the Duo. We're going to jump onto the Eko app again, and I'm going to show you that. It's going to show you the EKG here at the top, which is the electrocardiogram, and then we're going to be looking at the phonocardiogram here. All right, so that was the Eko app. Now we're going to jump on the desktop and go on to the Eko dashboard and show you that. Again, you can see at the top there is the EKG, and the bottom waveform is the phonocardiogram. I am going to show you what the lung sounds look like on the Duo as well, and that is the phononeumogram. Okay, so that wraps it up for the three, and you got a little taste of what the waveform looks like on all three. Share what your experience is up to this point. All right, let's wrap up this video. I'm going to link a PDF in the description below so that you can see it visually yourself. It will say ED's three stethoscope chart. I don't know what else to call it, but on the left side is going to be all the categories. On the top will be individual stethoscope, Thinklab, core, and duo. Just going to cover a couple things like what's the amplification for each stethoscope. I do my best to stay informed with the latest features and update, but I do work full-time as a nurse practitioner, as I mentioned, and I have to keep up to date with all the new researches and guidelines. So I'm a pretty busy lady. I hope this video was helpful for someone out there in the internet space. And if there is anything that's been helpful, please comment in the space below in the description place. And just let me know, or let everybody else know, what is your setup? What are you going to try? And how's it going talking to your audiologist about this? Do they know about it or do they not? Bunch of questions, huh? Pick one and talk about it. Always trying to help each other. Take care. Peace.